Hi, my name is Kaylee, and I'm going to be doing a film and philosophy video review on Kierkegaardian ethics. So the movie that I watched was Toy Story 3. For a basic little background, it was written by Walt Disney Productions, but its specific writers were John Lasseter, Andrew Stanton, and Lee Unkrich. And it was also directed by Lee Unkrich. And the screenplay was by Michael Arndt. So the main characters in the story are Woody, which is voiced by Tom Hanks, Buzz Lightyear, which is voiced by Tom Allen, Lotso by Ned Beatty, and Andy by John Morris. So a quick little overview of the plot of Toy Story 3. Basically, Andy is the owner of a bunch of toys who come to life, basically. And Andy is preparing to go to college, so his mom asked him to go through his room and get rid of a bunch of stuff. And as he does that, he grabs all of his old toys, including Woody and Buzz Lightyear and all the others, and he puts them in a trash bag, and his intention was to put them in the attic, but there was a mix-up, and they ended up getting put in the trash, which they got out of, and then they ended up being sent to Sunnyside Daycare, where the toys are really excited to be played with again, but the dynamic quickly changed as they were harshly thrown around by a bunch of little kids, and they were also under the strict rule of a evil little bear named Lotso. So eventually the toys realize that they don't want to deal with that, and they make a plan to escape Sunnyside Daycare and return back home. And eventually they find themselves back home where Andy gives them to their neighbor and they are loved and played with again. Kierkegaardian ethics are actually displayed pretty evidently in this plot. To begin, I'm just gonna tell you like what Kierkegaardian ethics are mainly about. So a lot of the main points was Kierkegaard was a Christian, and he realized that there were a lot of faults in people who were Christian and weren't actually living their faith. And so he noticed that a lot of people were teaching that man was created without a meaning, and that you could come up with your own meaning through your choices, and you could define that based off whatever your desires were. But he argues that a true relationship with God is not found in like your human experiences, which is what a lot of people are focused on, their worldly experiences and you are what you do kind of idea. But he says that it's through the state of a surrendered heart that leads to a true connection with God. First, in my perspective, I see the toys kind of representing man in that Andy represents their God, kind of, meaning that the toys are searching for a purpose and they are finding it in their God, which is Andy, in being able to give him enjoyment and interaction and them having entertainment, which kind of goes along with the narcissistic idea of Kierkegaardian views that a lot of people were only focused on themselves. As Andy grows up, he kind of matures and begins to neglect his toys, and they then are in search for a new meaning and are unsatisfied. And during this phase, a lot of his toys begin to lose their faith in him, and they lose their purpose, their feeling of purpose based off what they believe it is that they set for themselves. So in the same way, when Lotso's past was explained, they're explaining that he was once owned by a little girl named Daisy, and that one day he and a few other toys were forgotten.
One day we took a drive, hit a rest stop, had a little playtime. After lunch, Daisy fell asleep. Lotso wouldn't give up. It took forever, but we finally made it back to Daisy's. But by then, it was too late. Something changed that day inside Lotso. Something snapped.
She replaced us. Come on.
No, she only replaced you.
She replaced all of us, didn't she? She don't love you no more. Now come on!
We were lost. Cast off. Unloved. Unwanted.
And so he then began to make his own purpose for himself in ending up at Sunnyside Daycare, and he found purpose in watching others suffer and feel hurt just as he did, and beginning to take control of others. So in a lot of ways, Lotso confined to this worldview, finding purpose in being owned and wanted. And he spent a lot of time in what Kierkegaard calls the ethical stage, which is maturing but still not finding fulfillment. And this is when he decides to hold power to see others suffer just as he did, but still losing faith and never returning back to it. And that's how he found his purpose in hurting others and watching them suffer. But despite this, many of the other characters began to lose faith in Andy also, but the one who really seemed to hold on to faith a little bit was Buzz Lightyear. He still chose to believe in Andy, and ultimately he was the one who got all of the toys out of their situation and brought them back to Andy in the end. And on that note, Buzz was the only character that seemed to not embrace these ethics. He didn't lose his faith, and he was really the only one who held on to it. And I think that if all of the other characters were to conform, including Buzz Lightyear, that they most likely would have never returned back home to Andy. So the three stages that Kierkegaard addresses, the aesthetic stage, the ethical stage, and the leap phase. So in the plot, the aesthetic stage, where someone has bondage to their passions, they're self-focused, kind of stuck in their own ways. This can be seen when all of the toys that Andy was throwing away thought that he just was done with them and left them, when really it was a misunderstanding. The toys were upset that Andy was getting rid of them or just no longer playing with them, and so they desired to continue to fulfill their purpose in serving and entertaining him, and they didn't really want to accept the fact that he was changing and growing up. And then the ethical phase, that's when someone seeks discipline or structure. They begin to. They're still more on the narcissistic side, and they're not fully quite there of surrender. And so this is done in an effort to gain meaning or reach their purpose that they desire or have created for themselves. And this occurs when Lotso matured after his initial hurt of being replaced and him deciding to take his ownership and structure in the daycare through controlling others. And that's how he tries to find fulfillment. And it also shows his loss of faith, which backfired on him in the end. And he also followed the idea that Kierkegaard was saying a lot of people followed, that you don't have to be confined to others' ideas. He found his purpose in what he did, and he kind of made his own purpose for others also. And also the toys, when they were leaving to go to Sunnyside, they're really excited seeing that they get to go serve a new purpose and be given attention, trying to accept their belief that Andy didn't want them anymore, and their efforts to feel important and have significance eventually were controlled by Lotso, and so they were stuck under his control. And after this is the leap phase. So basically, this is when someone achieves their true connectedness to God through full surrender, and they're also gifted with other people for a purpose, and it given others just to allow them to function as a team. And so The biggest leap that was taken was when Buzz, Woody, and the rest of the toys realized that they had enough of everything going on and that they didn't want to continue to be bossed around by Lotso. So they started with searching to find the garbage chute and rebelling against him to do what's right and eventually return back to their god, Andy. And then also, the toys work as a team together, and none of them were going to leave the other ones behind. They even, when they thought that they were going to die, they all laid together and held hands in a circle, and they just accepted that it could have been the end for them. The last thing that I really noticed from a lot of Kierkegaardian philosophies was that a lot of people believe that everyone has some sort of immortal self or soul. And this is also kind of seen in the way that all of the toys are indestructible. They made it out of a garbage truck, and they also made it through the dump without getting incinerated. And were able to escape Lotso with his dictator-like rule over them. And so throughout this, they were basically immortal, where they couldn't be destroyed. So, critiques on the filmmakers' integration of the worldview concepts. I think that they did a pretty good job representing Kierkegaardian ethics. It was interesting that it was in a children's movie, where obviously no kids are really gonna catch that. And I think often adults don't even pick up on it unless they were to really think about it. So it's more subtle, but it also kind of seems to teach children that faith and dedication to a person or thing, not necessarily to a god, but to something, will save you in the end, as seen with Buzz Lightyear and how he continued to have faith in Andy. Lastly, when it comes to other worldviews that could have been included in Toy Story 3, the one that I really noticed that could have been another aspect was Marxism, through the fact that Lotso was really controlling and bossing all the toys around, almost like a dictatorship. I mean, not quite, but he definitely was ruling over people, and he was definitely hoping to not see them survive and had evil intentions. And in this case, everyone was treated equally in a way that they were all oppressed, which is different than Marxism, because normally it favors the oppressed and doesn't allow people to be treated differently. So yeah, that was everything that I noticed through my film review on Toy Story 3 with Kierkegaardian ethics.